going on, everybody? It's your boy, Nomus J, coming at y'all, man. This is officially day two of the NFL draft, rounds two and three, as y'all already know. I want to talk about day one. As it was announced, Detroit Lions had drafted Ohio State star cornerback Jeffrey Okuda with the third overall pick. I know a lot of people had a lot of issues involving that pick yesterday, but I'm not necessarily one of those guys. It was announced that Bob Quinn did not get any offers, the trade down, I should say, for the pick. So I know people are upset, but like I said, I'm actually cool with the pick. Get another cornerback in here that can make plays, man. I know it's been some controversy about his style of play or who was really like what was really responsible for his production and how long he was a starter and who he played against. But at the end of the day, all that means nothing to me personally, because if, let's say, there is a training camp and OTAs, you're going to be going up against guys like Marvin Jones, Kenny Galladay. If they do joint practices with teams this year, I know with the whole coronavirus thing, I'm not sure if a lot of stuff is going to go down. But let's just say theoretically, if you go with those usual expertise, you will be going against receivers that are very experienced and very good, or guys who, you know, are Pro Bowl level type talent, man. So at some point, he's going to get a chance to work against some top ranked guys. But like I said, this if the virus is not involved. But overall, you know, look, the kid is smart. He has a high IQ. You can't throw those things away. Bob Quinn can't stress enough. I know a lot of people felt they researched and through history of Bob Quinn's drafting style that he would take this route. Again, maybe he leaned on a couple of specific traits outside the usual five components of his way of drafting and finding talent. So maybe that's what it was, man. But like I said, all it means nothing to me. I know people are mad we skipped out on Isaiah Simmons, but at the end of the day, Lions did need help in the secondary. The linebacking core, I think, to me personally, if you want my honest opinion, to me, you need another solid veteran in that rotation that can actually step right in and make plays personally, as opposed to going to somebody, against someone out the draft with the third pick. Because the fact of the matter, you have Jamie Collins, Jelani Tavai, and Jared Davis. You need another guy, you know, that can at least be a help support, that can actually help be a quality depth at the linebacker position, that can play good and show some coverage mechanics, specifically coverage mechanics. Not necessarily an outside linebacker, but more of an inside guy who can rotate in on third down and stuff like that. I know Jamie Collins probably do a lot of that too, but I'm just saying that just have at least four guys that you can definitely count on game one. I actually would prefer the Lions run that route. Jeffrey Okuda, man, he's cool, man. I think for people have to understand, man, when you come as a cornerback, no matter how skilled you are, the one thing you got to have is confidence, man. One thing you really have to have is confidence to play the position, you know. So, and I know people are worried about how well is he going to play because we don't send pressure. That remains to be seen. Yeah, his defense doesn't send pressure, but it depends on how they're going to use Okuda, or even if they even use him like that this year. No, and I know it sounds crazy, but I mean, it's their team. They drafted the player, and now they have to be held accountable for the player. So it's not anything that the fans should really be upset about. Oh, if he doesn't start, it's not your pick. You know, it's the Lions' pick. They choose to get Okuda. That's who they're going with. I like to pick when you match him and Manny Warrior sometime down the line in the future, when those two are the top guys on the team, probably at cornerback. That's going to be something to watch, man, because they both have similarities, man. Both of them really smart guys that know how to play their position. If Manny Awarie held up pretty decently in a short amount of time, I think Jeff Okuda can do the same. This is not a panic move. I don't know why people are panicking. I know there's a lot of questions about Matt Patricia and Bob Quinn, if they were feuding on the draft pick. That remains to be seen. That we just got to wait till we hear more about it. It's no any point in trying to overwrap your head around it until you get more information. You know, I know people are going to come in and try to act like they know exactly what's going on. But, you know, to me, until I hear more information and tell a bad way to go about things, that's when I make my judgment on that. You know, but like I said, I'm satisfied with the draft pick. Patience is what this fan base need to have. Again, if they didn't go Okuda, and let's say they want offensive line, they still would need to work on that defensive line anyway. So I'm not really all that, you know, upset about the pick because we chose to get Okuda. You get the guys you really, really want. I don't care how you had to get them, you just get them. If they feel like Okuda could be helped, then that's what they're going to get. Guys can be helpful. You know, I'm not asking the guy to come out and be a Pro Bowler in his first year because he was selected third overall. I just want to see how well the Lions are going to do with him. That's all I'm concerned with. It's not the player I have a problem with, not at all. So we're going to see how well he develops. We'll see what his jersey number is. Again, he's going to play that position with confidence. I believe he's a confident guy. So that does mean something. As a DB, you have to be really confident, sometimes a little overconfident, because you're going against some top receivers. You got to show that you're a dog, and it's that only remains to be seen. I believe he can be. He's a baller. So y'all just stay and don't overcriticize the pick because you didn't get Isaiah Simmons. You know, it was multiple teams that did pass on him. If this guy was such a generational talent, the question still bears, why would other teams pass something? You know what I'm saying? Like, you got to look at that point, too. So, I'm going to leave it at, man. I ain't about to make this too long. I'll try to get with y'all later on tonight on Detroit Drew's channel for the day two draft. So, make sure y'all tune in sometime tonight. I don't know if it's 7 or 8. They disputing that now. But anyway, keep your eyes peeled. And shout out to everybody in DVE, DSA, the Outsiders. It's your boy, Nomus J. I'm out.